Tehachapi Pass, a massive granite wall that stands between San Francisco and Los Angeles. Prior to 1876, no locomotive could summit these steep, arid mountains. That is, until a workaround was built. This is the Tehachapi Loop, one of the most important engineering marvels in railroad history.
All right, you gotta take a look here. This is the front of the train. Down here at the bottom of the loop, still going. Some of these trains can be almost a mile long.
It may look like a train roller coaster from the sky, but according to historian Doug Pickard, it's actually more of a ladder.
So instead of going straight up a mountain,
couldn't do it.
Gotta take a slow winding.
Just like driving on a mountain road, you do switchbacks.
Doug is the founder of Friends of the Tehachapi Depot, a railroad museum which holds a variety of railroad relics.
How many signals are we talking in this area?
What is there, 12 or 15 here we've got, and they're from different parts of the country.
The depot is also the gateway to the Tehachapi Loop, which is one of California's most trafficked railroad mountain passes.
The only two places to get east out of California is Donner Pass and Tehachapi.
In 1869, the completion of the Transcontinental Railroad linked Sacramento to the East Coast, but at the time, trains were limited on how steep a hill grade they could climb.
2.2%, which meant for every 100 feet of track, he could go up 2.2 feet, like 26 inches.
On the Sierra through Donner Pass, engineers had plenty of routes to slowly ramp the track up the mountain 2 feet at a time. But at Tehachapi Pass, it was different.
What is the height difference from the bottom of the loop to the top of the loop here?
76 feet, and it was just way too steep from here up to here.
It was engineer William Hood who came up with the loop idea. And with the help of about 3,000 Chinese laborers, they laid the track in record time.
No, from the loop up to Tehachapi, down to Mojave, down to Lancaster, Palmdale, and up through Soledad Canyon in 2 months.
Thanks to the loop, Los Angeles would grow and prosper because people and cargo from the East Coast could travel back and forth from Northern California to Southern California, and eventually to New Orleans.
And still there. Every train that goes by here goes through there, you know, today.
The loop has remained relatively unchanged for more than 100 years. And thanks to efforts by Friends of the Tehachapi Depot, this loop overlook was built for train enthusiasts of all kinds to enjoy.
Let me tell you, coming up here 3-4 times a week, I've met people from all across the country.
From the Tehachapi Train Loop, I'm John Bartel. Hope to see you on the back road. Still going.